Welcome back to a new tutorial, Benoît Farine for Ben Explorer. In this module, we are going to talk about the very first steps that we'll need to know to start with Premiere Pro. I assume that Premiere Pro is already installed on your system, and if it isn't, then pause this video, install your product, and join me back when you are done. In this section, we will launch Adobe Premiere, we will go over the start screen options, we will go over the new project options, and we will create, save, and open an existing project. This will give us a high-level view on the major components and the interface of the application. When we open Adobe Premiere, the application will first display the start screen. So before we go ahead and create a new project, let's have a quick look at the start screen. The start screen or the welcome screen might look slightly different based on your version of Premiere, but the options are similar. The start screen opens with the work section. To create a brand new project, I would click New Project. To open a project I worked on previously, I would click Open Project. Team Project lets editors and motion graphics artists collaborate on projects within Premiere. This is an advanced feature, we will not cover it here. This area is currently empty, but as we work on projects, our recent projects will be listed here. We will be able to open projects directly from here, and note that we can also open project from the Open Project menu. The Learn tab provides access to application tutorials and tips on how to start with Premiere. Let's go back to the work area and hit New Project. The New Project dialog opens. There are a few options that I'll cover here. First, we will name our project. Enter Essentials. Then, we need to specify the location of the file on disk. Click Browse and navigate to the desktop. Create a new folder on your desktop. Type My Projects. And finally, click the Select Folder button. So our project is Essentials, and it will be saved under My Projects on the desktop. Let's have a look at the video rendering and playback option. If you have a graphics card with hardware acceleration installed on your system, I would strongly recommend that you make sure it is selected here. The graphics card hardware acceleration will significantly improve the performance of the application. Click here to see the cards installed on your system. When you select an item, a warning might show up and indicate that the card is unsupported. Your card will most probably still work, but the message is warning you that Adobe did not test that specific card. If you do not have a card installed with hardware acceleration on your system, use the software renderer option. Now click Scratch Disks. The scratch disk is where your media is stored. When you preview effects or various edits or transitions between clips, those previews must be rendered. The rendered clips are stored as preview files on the scratch disk. If your computer just has one big hard drive, then you won't have separate scratch disks. But if you have several hard drives installed on your system, then you would probably set up separate scratch disks, as this will improve the performance of your system. For example, you can dedicate one of your drives to capturing the audio and another to capturing video, and thus use different scratch disks to boost performance. The speed of a scratch disk matters much more than the size of the disk. In my case, I'll be using a single hard drive for everything. We are now ready with those settings. Let's go ahead and click OK. Premiere creates our new project, and we now see the interface. There are several panels and options here, and we will cover them later in this tutorial. Note that we haven't yet imported any media in our project, so everything is empty. Let's now relaunch Premiere and open the project we just created instead of building a new one. First, I will save my project, so I go to File, Save. I could also simply type Ctrl S or Option S. The project is saved as a file within the folder we created on the desktop. The name of the project can be seen here. Now we will relaunch Premiere and open the project we just created instead of creating a new one. First close Adobe Premiere, go to File, Exit. We relaunch the application and we wait several seconds for the start screen to display. From the start screen, click Open Project, navigate to your project folder. As you can see, it was saved on the desktop in the My Project folder. Select the project file and click Open. You can also open the project through the File menu, File, Open Project, navigate to your project folder, select the project. So in this section, I showed you how to launch Premiere. We looked over the start screen, we created a new project, we looked at the new project options, and we saved the project to a folder on the desktop. We then closed the loop by closing and restarting Premiere, and we opened the project that was created previously. Next, we will go over workspaces and the panels. These are the main UI components of Adobe Premiere. I will show you how to use and customize workspaces and adjust components of the interface in order to build the layout that best suits your working style.